Every substance in this universe has a mass. Hey everybody, this is Jay Sridhar from Grade 9, and today I'm going to crack our minds by talking about the little formula mass. Okay, let's get started with the topic today. Have fun with me. Okay, as on by name, the little formula mass is finding the mass of the elements in a compound. So now our question is, how do we find it out? Let me tell you how. Finding relative formula mass is very easy indeed. The formula of element or compound is taken as the basic unit, and then the masses of the atoms or ions in the formula are added together. Now, as you can see, this is the periodic table with all the relative masses of all the elements. Now, for example, let us take water, H2O. First, write down all the elements in water, that is hydrogen H and oxygen O. Next, what to do is to find the relative formula mass. Take the atomic mass of hydrogen, which is 1, and the number of elements in water is 2 hydrogen molecules. So 1 into 2, which is 2, and oxygen is 1 molecule in the water formula, and oxygen atomic mass is 16. So 2 plus 16, which is equal to 18, the relative formula mass of water. As I've explained you before, let's get going a bit more deeper. Now, the first one is ammonia, NH4. The elements in ammonia are nitrogen and hydrogen are 4 molecules. So, N is equal to 14.007, which is the exact atomic mass of ammonia. Next is hydrogen. The exact atomic mass is 1.01, and as it is 4 molecules, 1.01 into 4, which is 4.04. And now if you add 14.007 and 4.04, you will get 18.047 mg per mole, which is the relative formula mass of ammonia and H4. Next, moving on, it is AlCl3, which is aluminium chloride. There is 1 aluminium atom in this and 3 chlorine atoms. So Al is equal to 26.982 and Cl3 is equal to 35.45 into 3. So when you add both the values, you will be getting 133.332 mg per mole. It is not always necessary to write the whole value that you get. You can round it up to 3 significant figures. Moving on to sulfuric acid, H2SO4. There are 3 atoms in it, hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen. H2 atoms is 1 and O4. So 1.01 into 2, 2.02 hydrogen, 32.06 sulfur and 15.999 into 4 oxygen. Now, if you add all these values, you will get 98.076 mg per mole. Up next is magnesium oxide, magnesium plus oxygen, which is MgO. Mg is equal to 24.305 and O is equal to 15.999. When you add both, you get 40.304 mg per mole, which is the relative formula mass of magnesium oxide. Making it clear, relative molecular mass is same as formula mass. Hope you got it clear about how to find the relative formula mass of molecules. Let's take up a summary. First, you write down all the elements in the compound, and then you write down the number of each in the compound, and then you take their atomic masses, multiply together the numbers, and then add the total, and then find the relative formula mass. The SI unit is mg per mole. Thank you.